Next up for their draft grade are the Houston Texans. Now, when it comes down to the Texans last year, the biggest question mark is, can Deshaun Watson stay healthy and can we protect him? Those are two things that they just didn't know what it was going to be. Defensively, you knew what this team was going to be. They brought in Tyrann Mathieu on a one-year prove-it deal. He did what he was supposed to. And then you had Jadeveon Clowney. You had J.J. Watt. The defense was going to be set, and I think the defense was going to show up every Sunday. We knew that for the Texans. We just didn't know what Deshaun Watson was going to look like coming off that ACL and if they could truly protect him, because that was the reason why he got hurt. So we fast forward into the season. You think about this offensive line really hurt their run game, which then in turn hurt their pass game because they couldn't protect Deshaun Watson. And also they couldn't, you know, run the ball to protect him or anything like that. Like, they struggled as a team, in my personal opinion, offensive line-wise. So you go into the offseason, you think about some of the things that they need to address. Offensive line, was they going to retain Tyrann Mathieu? Like, they had a lot of question marks around in this team, especially in a tough AFC South. I think that came, well, it came down to the wire. And so with a tough AFC South, I think it literally was like, what can we do and what can we be? So the Texans are trying to maintain and hold that throne because they won the South, but they want to maintain, and like the Colts are nipping right at their heels. So it's going to be interesting to see what they do through this whole entire offseason process. So if you've been a footballer through this whole process, you already know my best pick or my favorite pick for the Houston Texans was Max Scarping. I think this guy is going to be a solid left tackle. Like I said, in the opening, they needed to fix their offensive line issues. This guy is going to be that guy. I felt like that he could be a 10-year tackle. They got him in the second round, which I felt like was a true steal. But I think he's going to be a guy in pass sets and pass protection. He's going to be a guy that Deshaun Watson can feel that has his back 110%. And he's going to definitely just going to overall help this offensive line. Now, he won't have the Quentin Nelson effect as far as improving everyone else's play. But I think his effect on protecting Deshaun Watson and just giving him that comfortable blanket, if you will, on his back. I think that that's what Deshaun Watson needs. Like, he's going to be comfortable now in the pocket with having a guy like Max Scarping. They also took Titus Howard at the other tackle position. I think he should play right tackle personally. So then you got two tackles in the same draft. So it's really going to help out the development of Deshaun Watson moving forward. Even though the development with the bad offensive line was going in the right direction, can you imagine now if he has this protection? It's going to be even more exciting. I think Max Scarping is the best and perfect pick for the Houston Texans. So one of my biggest knocks on the Texans draft class, in my personal opinion, was they did not go out and address the other wide receiver position. Now, you got Will Fuller coming back off injury. I understand that. We already know what D-Hop is. Now, this whole entire offseason, I've been talking about different offensive options, right? So their first offensive option, in my personal opinion, is going to definitely be D-Hop as far as the pass game goes. Then they're probably going to move to the run game, and then you got Will Fuller taking the top off. Now, what killed them last year is they even went out and they traded for Demaryius Thomas in the middle of the season. They needed that next weapon. They needed that other weapon. The tight end position was kind of fluctuating between a good player and a bad player. Like, they really couldn't hone in on one tight end. They went out and drafted Cahill Waring, which is another guy that I'm in love with. I think he's a solid player. I'm excited to watch him play. I think he's the Travis Kelce 2.0, but that's yet to be seen. But they go out and get Kyle Waring in the draft, which I think is really smooth, but they didn't have that other offensive weapon option as far as the wide receiver goes. So maybe this year the lineup options are going to be different. Definitely D-Hop for the first option. Then we got run game for second option. And then we're going to rely on Will Fuller to take the top off and then open up things for those tight ends. And that's it. Like, we're just going to keep it clean cut and dry. And then maybe a couple other receivers might come on and get a couple catches here and there. But I really feel like that they needed that other wide receiver, and that was my biggest knock on this class. Other than that, I think it was a perfect draft class. With that being said, when you're the Houston Texans and you're a flawed team, especially in one area of your team, and you go out of your way to make sure that you address that need as much as possible, you deserve an A, especially when it's the offensive line, especially when it's trench play. They went out and they addressed their offensive line. They got, you know, Titus Howard. They got Max Scarping, which I'm in love with. They got Cahill Waring, who's another receiving threat at the tight end position, which is all exciting and is going to be nice and it's going to be perfect. And I think that they noticed their needs and they went out and addressed their needs. They got a couple other good guys through free agency and things like that, but that's not for here. I just feel like that the Houston Texans attacked this draft with the right mindset of that we need to protect our franchise quarterback. If Deshaun Watson is going to be our guy for the next, you know, 8 to 10 years, we need to do whatever we can to make sure that he's going to be upright for those next 8 to 10 years. And they know for a fact when he goes down, they just don't have a fighting chance. So they really went out of their way to make sure that he's going to be upright for quite some time, at least for this 2019 season. So if you're a Texans fan, definitely give this video a big thumbs up. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Are there some other guys that came out in this draft class that you're excited about? Not undrafted, because I know they got a couple of good guys undrafted. But through this whole entire draft class, is there a guy that I didn't spotlight? Am I just too, like, Max Scarping happy or whatever? But let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. I'm always here for debate. I'm always listening. I'm always in the comment section. So I definitely want to hear from you guys and what you think. And if you're not a footballologist yet, become a footballologist today and subscribe to the YouTube channel. And stay safe, football fans.